Hello everybody, today something a bit exotic, you could say. I'm talking about Chinese knives that are very affordable. Well, they're all here between $8 and 9 and a bit. From the company brand B. And you can see that here written on the blade. Which, if I am correct, because it's really not evident to research that, if I'm correct, it's actually a brand from the Chinese manufacturer Enlam, who also acts as an outsourcing partner, according to their website, for companies like Gerber and Buck and SOG. So they also probably have make at least materials, or maybe even the complete knives of the, you could say, of the affordable lines of these manufacturers. I am almost certain this is the same brand, because these knives are also available under the Enlam brand, which have their own website. So what will I examine here? Well, this is the L02, the L06 version 1, the other one as a whole, L05 version 1, the other one I believe as a synthetic handle, and then quite the beastly thing, the EL01. So like I said, indeed, knives from China, typically I believe mainly sold at the internal market. Some now begin also to come to the Western market, and especially if you're hunting around, if you're interested in knives, like obviously I am, then you come across, for example, shops in Hong Kong or Asia that sell these online at a really, really good price, actually. So already, as a premature conclusion, I can tell you that if you are really on a budget, these B knives are really, really all pretty impressive for the low price. I can understand why Western companies outsource their entry level series to a company like this one, or Sanrenmo is another one that I will discuss discuss later. So I would still say, if you're really seriously interested in knives, I think I would still recommend to start with the Swiss Army knife, with an Opinel, with the Mora, that kind of thing. But still, these are pretty good, and also they make very nice gifts, actually, for people who are it's a gift that costs less than a CD, actually, and they're really not embarrassing in any way. They're really pretty well made, as we will see. So let's start here, I would say, because, well, I do four knives in one video. It will all be quite concise. With the L02, this is a perfectly neutral utility knife. Look, it's very nicely made. That is as a G10 handle with some grooves in it, so that, to make it slightly more interesting, you could say, a 3-inch blade, 7 centimeters, 98 grams heavy, like most of them except the biggest one, 3 millimeter thick stock, and the steel is 8 CR13 MOV. That's the same steel as the Tenacious has, which is a pretty good mid-range steel, quite comparable, you could say, in performance with 440C. I must say, by the way, I'm not certain about it, but sometimes you see Chinese knives or Western brands with their Made in China series, where it says for their entry level product sometimes says 440C, but I wonder if it's not this one, actually, instead of real 440C. But anyway, decent mid-range, as anybody with a Tenacious will agree. And here's a bit of jimping on the liner. The liner itself is it 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter thick? Oops, this is the wrong one. Wrong side here. Let's see. 2 millimeter thick liner, so it's nicely adjusted to the left. Now, what, of course, this is actually part of a passer hand from the British blade forms. I didn't buy all these knives, actually, so I used them a bit to see a bit if I would like them. I didn't heavily use them, and it's true with liner locks. Okay, these are now nicely adjusted. You actually have to use them. Having carried them on you for more than a month, and use them every day to begin to appreciate if they are indeed well adjusted. Well, We will see that over time from reactions of other people. A bit of jimping here. So it's really a neutral utility knife. Ah, and it's a hollow ground. And it's reasonably sharp out of the box. So neutral utility knife, pretty good. this one I think is optically the most interesting one. It's that was the L06 version 1. The other one has a kind of an ellipsoid spider hole kind of hole. What are the main differences? Well, it's the same steel, but it's a bit heavier, 114 grams. Well, and the length of the blade, now you see it's a bit difficult to measure here, but here the cutting edge, if you put the ruler, it's 7.5 centimeter, 3 inches. Because of here, it has a kind of a coil, but it's just next to the sharp part, you can grip it quite close. Usually I'm not particularly interested in things like jimping, but if you would use grab this close for some precision work, well, it could have used a bit of jimping there. But still, otherwise, I think this is pretty nice. I must say, when you hold it further, you see, because of this curvature, I don't think actually it's that good in the hand as the previous one. Again, very pure, open manufacturing. The clips are for except the biggest one, they are all for tip-down carry. This clip looks relatively good. And here the two colors, actually two kinds of G10. I think this is pretty nice. Look and feel, it's a nice gift I think. This one looks more traditional. A traditional kind of hunting folder, which, you know, it has a flat ground, which I actually prefer. For general use I prefer flat grinds. I always think it cuts better than hollow ground. It looks a bit like those Swedish designed Falkniven folders in my opinion, or even some of the fixed blades. It has a bit that kind of look and feel of them, but it's not a copy. While indeed sometimes these Chinese brands have some knives that are inspired by Western designs, but here in this case I wouldn't say that's the case at all. They are quite original with perhaps some design influences, but okay, there's nothing wrong with that. What I also wanted to say here, look, it is nicely fitted. There's not too much opening here between the blade and the handles, which you sometimes have. I will close this here, and I think, yeah, you see, it is nicely centered. They all are actually, they open reasonably smoothly. And also here the locks well. Notice this is a rosewood handle, but here this, you see it already on my camera, this is a bit a kind of a rougher area, so that would benefit from a bit of sanding and repolishing. Well, okay, like I said, it's between $8 and $9, something like that. So in general, the quality is what you have from the better made Magnum, Boker Magnum knives, which you probably have already handled. So these are indeed, for a good price, reasonable knives with a reasonable steel. I mentioned it, HCR13, same as Spyderco Tinacius and a few other well-known knives, good mid-range. I forgot to say this is 108 grams, so it's a bit lighter than this one. Probably the wood is less dense. Also 3 mm thick stock, tip down carry with a clip that way, and the blade is 8.7 centimeters. But I thought, I forgot where I actually measured it. Let's see that together. Indeed it's around 8.7, and here, but the cutting edge is a bit shorter than if I would just put it like that. It's well, there's still 8.5, because of the triangle effect. You can also grab it a bit closer, but it's not really designed for it. But this one is really good in the hand. Now, to end with the beast, I would say. This is really, really convincing. I also think it's extremely ugly. It's the EL01, but it is a really serious utility folder. It's everything on it is heavier made than the previous ones. The blade is 4 mm thick. It's a hollow ground. It's not flat from here, it's hollow. You can feel it a bit. It has a flipper. I will demonstrate that. Jumping all over, it's a bit in that context, it feels a bit in the hand like the Spyderco, the new Manix. So that you have a really good grip everywhere. G10. Very nicely made. And it is a tip up carry, last befits some, you could say, somewhat more tactical kind of blade. And also quite a sturdy liner look actually. So this is 2 millimeter and a half, I think. Yeah. 2.5 millimeter thick. So really, really quite good. The flipper here works also good as a finger guard. So really, if you're a low budget, heavy utility knife, you can do a lot worse than this. I think it's technically the most convincing, even if I think it's not good. It doesn't look good at all. So I mean, if you are used to it, you can actually with a little movement of the hand and at the same time tipping the flipper, open it like that. Otherwise you open it with two hands. So with this, yeah, really the EL01, if you're looking for a high toughness utility knife for a really good price, it's fantastic. Notice also here the stopping of the blade is thicker than on the other models. Everything on it is more sturdily made. You can see that the left stopping is thicker than that one. Really, really remarkable. So yeah, I think I was pleasantly surprised and happy to be part of this pass around. As I mentioned, if you're beginning, if you're seriously interested into knives, I would rather begin with one of the low-priced classics like an Opinel. But still, if you just want one knife and you need an utility knife for a good price, this one is especially remarkable. If you're another view is, let's say that you quickly want to build a nice collection, you say, oh, I could buy these four knives. And I don't pay much, and I still have already a choice of quite different styles, especially if you explore their catalog, quite different styles. Well, I must say, in that case, I would rather say, no, well, if you are prepared to spend a bit more in the beginning of your collection, then instead of four or five of these B knives or San Remo knives, I think you should buy something like a Spyderco Delica or Spyderco Endura, a really high quality design, and just one knife, but then really, in fact, a higher level still of quality. That's what I would do. But if you're like me, you already have a number of knives, these are really a fun way to expand with other designs. So yeah, I hope you found this interesting. Yeah, cheap but cheerful, not cheap and nasty, that's what I would say. And you can see the quality these days is really pretty convincing. This utility knife is really quite something, I have to tell you. So, I hope you found this interesting. Goodbye.